Good evening. We'd like to welcome you to our second night of AA Orchestra Festival here in Missoula. Welcome back, those of you who were able to attend that marvelous concert we had last night, and welcome to Hellgate. We've had a great 2 days, and I think there are two reasons for that. The first is that the kids came to us really well prepared. So I'd like to have those directors from the six individual orchestras stand up, if you would. I see Mr. Holland back here, Mr. John, Ms. Lozani. I can tell you now, if that work is not done, this becomes a really long 2 days. And it was done beautifully. The second, I'll do that later. I'd like to now take a moment to, the bio, there's a bio of our first conductor in the program. And I think you can certainly read that. I can just tell you that he's worked extremely well with our students over the last couple of days, offering them his own insight, his tips, for not only the music that the kids are playing, but hopefully some transference of knowledge for whatever they choose to play in their school orchestras and beyond. So that's the kind of thing that we hope for, and that's what we've seen, and it's been terrific. So would you please welcome to Missoula, Dr. James McWhorter.
Thank you. microphone, but I don't need one. I have really enjoyed working with your children, and they have been excellent musicians. They came with a desire to make music and learn as much as they could from what I could offer, and it was just a great pleasure. And again, I have to reiterate what Mr. Ritter said. They were so well prepared when they got here by their teachers that I think they gained immeasurably more from that. So thank you for having such wonderful children and letting me play with them a little bit tonight.
Thank you. We would like to thank you for an amazing 2 days. It has been an amazing experience.
I
Thank you very much for being here tonight, and we'd like to introduce our second conductor and the second festival orchestra. Mr. Nakahara comes to us from Spokane, where he's the assistant conductor for the Spokane Symphony, but he also has just taken a position with the Jacksonville Symphony, yes, the one down in Florida, so his frequent flyer miles will start to build up here as we go. We are so pleased to be able to have him join us, and his work with the students has been outstanding. Please welcome back to Missoula, Morihiko Nakahara.
such a pleasure to come back to Missoula after I was here last season in the fall, and it's just great to be back. I just love this town and the people, and to be able to work with these students have been such a treat for me these last 2 days, so thank you so much for that. We have three pieces for you, two of which have to do with Super Tuesday and Fat Tuesday. Not really. Well, loosely, yes. We opened our portion with the overture to an opera called Nabucco by Italian composer Giuseppe Verdi. It has to somewhat do with Super Tuesday because it deals with patriotism. And of course, you know the story of in the Old Testament, it deals with the captivity of the Hebrew people in Babylon. That's what the opera is about. And Verdi identified with the theme because when he wrote the opera in northern Italy, they were fighting for their own independence as well. So this opera and the theme you just heard from the opera sort of became the rallying cry for the Italian people. And also the piece also cemented his reputation as one of the leading opera composers, made him so famous that, well, frankly, if he were to run for the president back then, he probably would have won. Now there's a slight change in the from the pre-tip program. We will now be performing the Elegy by John Corigliano, who is an American composer who just turned 70 years old. And this is his one of earliest works. And he wrote this, for those of you who might not be familiar with the music of John Corigliano, he was the one who wrote the music soundtrack to the film The Red Violin. I don't know if any of you have seen that. He supplied the music for that and actually won the Academy Award for his efforts. And this dates from the 60s. And he dedicated it to a fellow American composer who was his senior, Samuel Barber, who is well known for his adagio for strings, so you probably have heard a gorgeous piece. So he tried to replicate that sense of long line. This is called Elegy. It's actually quite intense at points. You will hear something that sounds like something is breaking. That will be sort of the snap pizzicato that you will hear from the basses. It's not just a normal pizzicato, but it's a very much a harsh kind of pizzicato that you hear that you're afraid that someone's breaking trees or something. Do not fear, that's just the basis, that's what we always say. So here is Elegy by John Corigliano. Thank you.
On behalf of the Sentinel, Big Sky, and Capitol High School Orchestras, we'd just like to extend a big thank you. You've done an amazing job working with us, and you've made what could be 2 days of grueling practice into something really fun. So here's just a little something to remember us by.
As I promised, a piece that has remotely something to do with Fat Tuesday, as in the famous dance bacchanal from the opera Samson and Delilah. Fat Tuesday in the sense that, well, supposedly this is the day to let your hair down and have some fun. No pun intended, I'm sorry. About Samson. Of course, I thought you caught that. I will have to never use that one again. It was written by French composer Camille Saint-Saëns, and French in the 19th century, well, French I believe still do today, they loved grand spectacle. So the grand biblical story of Samson and Delilah, they're falling in love, and the conniving and the deceit and the last heroic effort by Samson, all of these things were perfect for operatic subject and became such a popular opera. This is Dance Bacchanal, occurs toward the beginning of the opera. As you can tell probably from the music, they're just having a good time. And in the middle of that, this is where supposedly Samson and Delilah first fall in love. So the middle section, the gorgeous theme played by the strings, that's sort of the love theme. It's the meeting of the two lovers at a party, so to speak. And well, and then it ends in a very festive manner. And again, it's been such a joy to be back here in Missoula, and I hope you enjoy the concert. And here is Samson and Delilah, Dance Bacchanal.
Thank you. Have a safe trip home.